In this video, I want to talk about CPU benchmarks for 3.17.4 and then look a little bit ahead to 3.18 and maybe what to expect. We've got a load of testing. I've done even more testing now of my Ryzen 1600, 2600 and 3600 just to get benchmarks for everything that I've got for 3.17.4. Because as we well know, Gen 12 renderer is going to hit in 3.18 and I want to be able to compare the data from before that to after that, so 3.17.4 versus 3.18, and we're nearly there. In this video, I'll just show you what we've got, the state of play really for CPUs as they stand right now, and it's actually a little bit more interesting than I thought it would be, because since I tested these Ryzen CPUs a while back, things have changed actually quite a lot. The game has become more playable, but also the number of players in each server has gone up, so it's been an interesting thing. So let's get into it. The graphs will come up as I'm talking, but what's really interesting, I think, about all these graphs is how playable now the 3600 has become. If you compare to what we tested a while back when I did my Ryzen comparison, we saw that the 3600 was only averaging in low level 32.3 FPS average. Now we're looking more at 41.5, and that's much better. It means there's much fewer drops below 30 FPS, and it's become really quite playable for this game. And again, as I always say, playable for size isn't, doesn't mean playable for any other game. But a few years ago, say 3-4 years ago, if you'd said you could get that performance in it with any CPU, you'd be pretty shocked. And it's quite impressive now how the engine is starting to become slightly more optimized and we're starting to get better performance with these lower end CPUs. The 1600 and the 2600, I would probably steer clear of, or if you've got one and you want a really minimal minimal cost upgrade, I'd try and get on at least the 3600. Those other two, the bottom there, they're just not brilliant and they don't perform particularly far apart from each other, which I was a bit confused by, but it could be to do with the amount of level 3 cache. They've both got exactly the same, whereas the 3600 has got double, and maybe, as we're seeing with the 5800X3D, the game engine is more and more cache hungry as time goes on, and the tweaks and the changes to the engine they make, maybe it's worth looking at with some older CPUs how much level 3 cache they have. But that's really all there is to say about those two, probably steer clear. But in general, this really is just an overview of where we're at, and I want to talk a bit about 3.18, because what are we expecting from the Gen 12 renderer? There are parts of the game, as we look here at this render scene that I've started testing, there are parts of the game where the render thread, which is the thread that sends everything to your GPU, is really under a lot of pressure. And so we are hoping that those parts of the game will see improvements in the render thread performance. My question is, and we'll test this exactly, we'll be able to find out basically what's going on, is the main thread, which is the thread that is basically doing all the game logic, everything else basically, I don't think there's many parts of the game where the render thread is slower than the main thread, if that makes any sense. So it might be that if you speed up the render thread, well, if we've not done masses of work to the main thread over the last however many months that CIG have been working on this stuff, will we see any difference? And that will be the testing that I'll do. I'm basically going to rerun all these tests in 3.18 and we'll be able to get an idea of where we see performance improvements. There's been some talk amongst people thinking, well, high-end CPUs won't really see any performance and maybe low-end CPUs will see lots of performance. But we don't know. We don't know, and I don't know if CIG even knows, really, until we've got it in our hands en masse, because they can do some testing internally, but they obviously can't do the amount of testing that the thousands of people that will play the game will do for them. And that's part of what this is, trying to give some feedback to CIG to show them which CPUs are performing and which are not with the new update. The thing that's worth saying is that Sylvan, who has been becoming more and more of a legend, I think, in the CIG community, he's very good, very active on Spectrum and really helpful in the stuff he's posting. He's recently posted this, and again, a reminder that they've not optimized anything for 3.18. They've just got the Gen 12 renderer in. And so I think we have to just hold our horses, not expect masses and masses of performance to suddenly just come out the air. But they are committed to more and more optimization over the year. And then obviously we're moving towards Vulkan, and he is optimistic for 2023, which everybody is always optimistic at CIG for the next year. But I think in this case, getting this in will be really significant, but it will be fascinating to see whether we actually see performance improvements and whether that main thread that again is churning through so much, and the graphics team have often said, well, actually, it's not actually our fault, that it's the engine team's responsibility to sort out the main thread. We're not, I don't think we're render thread bottlenecked in many parts of the game as we currently stand, and so I don't know how much performance we will gain from 380. But there we go. That's enough for this one. If you like this more technical look at Star Citizen, please subscribe, like. Massive thank you to the members. Feel free to be a member if you want to give some money towards the cause, and join the Discord where we can chat about all this sort of stuff, and it's many more people who are much more knowledgeable than me there. So see you soon, mate.